Have an update on the speakership race. News reaching us is that President Yoweri Museveni, in his capacity as the national chairman of the National Resistance Movement, has actually met with Speaker Rebecca Kadaga and her deputy Jacob Olanya on the matter of the speakership race. The president is said also to have met with members of parliament in the NRM who want to stand for the position of deputy speaker. We have this report. It is alleged that in 2016, SEC made an unwritten resolution that Jacob Olanya should withdraw his bid for speakership to allow Kadaga take another term, but she would also cede the seat to him in 2021. But now this seems far from being attained, given the high pace at which Rebecca Kadaga is conducting campaigns for her speakership for the 11th Parliament.
We take a position, support my candidature. My candidature is not a candidature for Busoga, it's a candidature for the East, it's a candidature for Uganda.
We have also learned that Museveni is set to meet NRM members seeking the deputy speakership position. These include Jacob Oboth Oboth, representing West Budama South, Thomas Tayebwa of Ruhinda North, Theodore Sechikubo of Lwemiyaga, Robin Aruakojo of Gomba West, and Anita Among of Bukedia District Woman MP. Meanwhile, members of parliament coming up in the 11th parliament from Bugisu and Sebei regions have joined the other teams that have endorsed Kadaga for speakership come May in the new political term.
Imbala City was not there completely. Could they removed it? Until when she brought it, we said no. And when Koni started praying, you know she loves praying when we are fighting on floor of parliament. When Koni started praying and we moved it, we said some of us, the Changomachos, were your teachers in Imbala. And we said we shall fight with Koni. Kadaga ruled, but is now a city. How do we leave such a woman?
Sebei region has 9 members of parliament. And I want to report to you that today we have 6 of us are here. Thank you so much, Madam Speaker. We have now taken a very strong stand to give you our support.
The teams from Bugisu and Sebei sub-regions today converged at Hotel Africana and endorsed Rebecca Kadaga as their candidate for the speakership race.
Among the 20 topmost people in Uganda, it is only a woman. Only one like this, and she is the one. So which mistake can we make as women? Let's stand with her. Because she does not discriminate whether you are small or big. She moves with all of us.
It's like people think that we are going to die tomorrow, so that there is no any other type for them to be leaders. And that's why I'm saying, Madam Speaker, we are supporting you for the same seat.
Speaker Kadaga reminded the team of how she fought so hard for Mbale to gain city status because it wasn't originally on the list. But with the city, they now have more MPs to represent their issues in parliament.
One of the major battles I had to fight was one of the city. Because when the proposal came, Mbale was not there. So I got 3 delegations and I armed myself with all these. These members came, the chairman, Mujasi came, the youth came. So I armed myself with all these petitions. I went to the president. I said, Your Excellency, I'm the national vice chair of the party, but you're causing me problems. How would I go to Soroti via Mbale when they have no city? Jinja has got a city, Mbale has not. You help me, give the people Mbale their city. So that's how it started. And then the city came. Otherwise, it would have been. You would have come at a later stage.
Both regions agree that Kadaga has been helpful with the infrastructure development of the region in terms of roads, schools and electricity.
You asked us about the state of the road in Sebei. We told you that the construction is going on slowly. The establishment of the road is halfway to the border. And you immediately called somebody in UNRA. But I want to assure you that the following day, a team went to Sebei, up to Bukwa, and they started clearing the road for us.
There is no caller, not even a single caller, who called in and said, you give another candidate. Everybody is saying, don't make any mistake. And they are wishing that if there was an opportunity for every Ugandan to vote, but Honorable Speaker, the sky would be the limit.
This story was compiled by Rachel Nakasi and Obed Lutale for the news.